Hi, and welcome back to the PySQL online class. In this video, we're going to install, configure, and test PyOLEDB Provider and PyOLEDB Enterprise. Let's begin by running the installation kit for PyOLEDB Enterprise 2017 R2. You can obtain this from the tech support download site if you don't already have it. You're going to right-click on the file and select Run as Administrator. As you can see from the installation kit, PyOLEDB Provider, PyOLEDB Enterprise, and PySQL Commander Lite are part of this install. We'll click OK, and I'll skip ahead in the video to the finish of the installation. Great, the installation completed successfully. So now let's go ahead and open up PySQL Commander. PySQL Commander is an application that's developed to appear like SSMS, SQL Server Management Studio, and to provide basic functionality for PySQL queries. So in the application, we can see the Object Explorer on the left shows OLEDB data sources, PyOLEDB Enterprise, and PyOLEDB Provider. Now the PyOLEDB Enterprise lists out your AF server, and your PyOLEDB provider lists out your data archive. Let's start by investigating how these servers appear in the list. Let's open up About PySDK, and let's show the Known Servers table. Here we have just PySRV01, which matches what we have here. Now, if I were to add another server, let's call it dummy. It's a dummy server, and I'll uncheck confirm, that way it'll let me add it. Now dummy is in my KSD, so if I right click on PyOLEDB Provider and select refresh, we now see dummy in the list. We don't actually want this server though, so let's go ahead and remove it. Okay, so now to connect to the PyData archive, let's right click on the server name and select connect. Let's not worry about this screen just yet. So we'll click OK. And we see a bunch of catalogs that are things like PyArchive, PyBatch, etc., etc. We'll go through the whole schema in a later video, so for now, let's just make sure that we have basic functionality and that our queries can work. So let's go through PyArchive and open up the tables, and we'll do an interpolated value query. So we'll look at PyInterp2, and on any of these tables, if you right-click on them and say Execute Predefined Query, it'll execute a basic query that's usually using a tag such as sinusoid, and we'll see that we get values. So these interpolated values for the last hour and now for sinusoid. So the fact that this returned values means that our installation is successful for PyOLEDB Provider. Next, let's create a view to confirm that the basic functionality of creating database objects is valid. Let's first copy this query to the clipboard and go down, right-click on Views, Create View. Let's paste in this query that we had before. Name this test view. Execute that. Command completed successfully. And now let's go down to views, right click, refresh. Now we see test view. Let's right click on that, execute predefined query. Here we see the same values as before, but we're executing this time test view as opposed to the PyInterp2 explicit query. Let's explore where that was saved. So close out About PySDK. Let's open up Py System Management Tools. Let's go to Operation Module Database. And we'll drill down to see PySQL, Catalogs, PyArchive, Views, Test View, Properties. And under Definition, we see the query that we had in the select statement. So what this means is that the query is being saved in the module database, and therefore it's on the server. every client that's using PyLDB Provider would have access to this data and therefore to the view configuration. So if you create the view on one machine and refresh your views on another machine, you should see the view appear. Great. Now that this is working, let's go ahead and close it out. And let's show one final test to make sure everything works the way we expect it to. We'll go back to our PyInterp2 query, and we see that we have a time step of 1 hour. And if we change this to 1 day for the time range, we'll see that our time step is still 1 hour. Our times are all increasing by 1 hour. And we have our time step column over here. Now, what if we want to specify a time step of something other than an hour? We can add that to the query, but we can also do it from the connection properties itself. So let's open up the user guide for PyLDB Provider, which you can find in the installation folder. So let's go to PyHome, OLEDB, doc, and then let's open up PyOLEDB Provider 2017 R2 user guide. Scroll down to the table of contents, and let's look for I supported OLEDB initialization properties. This is a list of all the initialization properties you can provide when connecting to the PyOLEDB provider. I'm going to show an example of using one that's called default time step. I'd encourage you to read through this guide to see all the different properties that you can use on your own while I show the functionality of using default time step. So, let's go back to PyLDB Provider and PySQL Commander. Let's right-click and disconnect. Let's reconnect. So in this screen that I glossed over before, let's click Options. And this brings us to a list of options that we can specify. Under Extended Properties, this is where you would put something in that is not one of the already defined boxes. So I'm going to put in default time step equals 6H. So now, if I do not specify a time step in my interpolated queries, I'm going to use a time step of 6 hours. So let's click OK. And let's just rerun this query. Notice now that all my time steps are 6 hours. This concludes the testing of the PyLDB provider portion of the installation. So let's go ahead and disconnect from the data archive, and let's move on to PyLDB Enterprise, and let's connect to our AF server. Now, I suggest using PySystem Explorer when writing PyOLEDB Enterprise queries, because PySystem Explorer lets you visualize the hierarchy and see your elements and attributes in their hierarchical manner while writing your queries. So we're going to start with connecting just to database 1, which is a very simple database made just for this tutorial. It has one element called test element. It is a template. And it has two attributes, a value of 1 and a value of 2 for test attribute 1, test attribute 2. So when we connect to database 1 in PySQL Commander, we see four different schemas listed: asset, data, data T, and event frame. We'll go over the schemas in a future video. So for now, let's just explore asset, table, and let's do element. Right click, execute predefined query, and we should see one element returned with the name test element. If we look, this is what we have for the test element. So that is the correct functionality. We confirmed that the PyOLEDB Enterprise query is returning what it should in this case. So now let's do the same thing with the view that we did for PyOLEDB Provider, and let's copy this query to the clipboard. Let's go down to Views. Let's create a view. Paste the query and name this testAFView. Let's execute it and confirm that command completed successfully. Now to show you where the view was just created, let's go back into Pi System Explorer and we'll connect to the configuration database. Explore OSIsoft, PySQL, Database Objects, Database 1, Asset, Test AF View. Under General, we can look at the extended properties, and we can see the query that we pasted in. This is our view, and as this is stored server-side, just like it is in PyOLEDB Provider, any client can access this view once it's been created by one client. All they have to do is refresh their views. So let's do that now. Let's refresh our list of views, and we see test AF view. Execute predefined query, and here we have the exact same results. This was a successful test. One final thing I wanted to show is the data flow that I went over in the previous video. I'd like to show how that corresponds with PyOLEDB Enterprise Agent. Let's open up services.msc, and we see PyOLEDB Enterprise Agent. If we were to stop this service and try to execute this query again, it would fail. Cannot connect to PyOLEDB Enterprise Agent. This makes sense because the data flow is routing through the PyOLEDB Enterprise Agent service. Now, I mentioned in the previous video that we can have the option of not doing that and having it go directly to the AF server. I'd like to demonstrate that. So let's right-click, disconnect, right-click, connect, and this time under Options, Recenter Properties, let's type in use agent equals false. Let's click connect. We've connected successfully. Now let's refresh the query, and we see that we have our results. We can confirm that the service is still stopped. This proves that we are successfully able to use or not use the PyOLEDB Enterprise Agent when using PySQL Commander. This concludes the video on installation, configuration, and testing of PyOLEDB Enterprise and Provider.